Hi everyone, welcome again. Now, we all know that to mod water pumps in EPANET, we need pump covers. Okay, we need pump covers, but there are some situations where pump covers might not be available, especially when you are dealing with old water pumps or when you are dealing with any existing water pumps but with no any documents. Okay, so with those two cases, the only thing that you can have access with is power rating, of course, in kilowatts. Now we are going to learn how to use power rating in kilowatts to model this water network here. Okay, so this is our pump and this is power in kilowatts. That being said, I'll surely see you in the next part of the video. Okay, let's get started. So this is a simple sketch of our network. Of course, this is existing project, so this is a simple sketch of it. Now remember, this is our submersible water pump, and again this is our ground level. Again, here is our destination point, which is a storage tank. Simple as that. So our pump here, elevation is 0, again ground level elevation is 50, and storage tank elevation is 100 meters. Okay, so from our pump all the way to down level, we have a pipe, of course, with 1.5 inches diameter pipe, and again length from this point here all the way to this point, we have 50 meters, and again, so from ground level all the way to our storage tank, again we have another pipe with 230 meters and 2.5 inches pipe. Okay, so this is what we have, but the only thing that we don't have is that. So we don't have pump cap. So the only parameter that we do have is power. Of course, power rating in kilowatts, and power rating for this pump that we want to model is again 2 kilowatts. Remember, put your power rating in power, not in pump caps. Okay, power. So it is 2 kilowatts. Okay, it is just that. Now, what we need to see, let me inspect everything if it is okay. So here is 0, and again here is 0, 50, again here is 100. So our network is ready. So remember, this is 2 kilowatts, because this is the only parameter that we do have. Now let me run and see what we have. So everything is okay. Let me see pressure. Okay, so this is our pressure. Remember, we did not have a pump curves, so we managed to know that our pump is pushing, or our pump total dynamic head is 112 meters. Again, let me see discharge. So at 112 meters, our pump is discharging 1.82 liters per second. Okay, so even though we have only power rating, so according to this model, tell us that our pump has a capacity of 1.8 liters per second and total dynamic head, or total pumping head, of 112 meters. So that is how we model pump if we don't have pump curves. The only thing that you need to have is power rating, of course, in kilowatts. So if you have your power, you can just insert here and then run your model. Okay, run your model. So as far as our pump is concerned, discharge is 1.8 and total pumping head is 112 meters. So it is simple as that. Remember, if you're new here, we have a lot of contents related to EPANET, so just go to our channel and make sure you watch those videos. Again, I'll make sure I include in the description below another video which explain how to use EPANET to model water pumps. That being said, I'll see you in the next video.